Good evening in the Buffers. Today I have something totally special for you. We're investigating LA life. We're actually at the Good Luck Gallery and we're gonna be showing you a special showing of an incredible artist. Her name is Anna Nemotova. And our curator, Paige, is gonna tell you what makes this so amazing. Ready to come join you with us? Hi in the Buffers. Today we're here with Paige Wiry and the actual artist is Anna Zumukova. Can you believe I said that? I'm not even Polish. Well, we're at the Good Luck Gallery and we're here with Paige and she's gonna tell us what makes this art so amazing. Paige?
Hi. Anna Zumukova's work is very special. We're showing it here in California for the very first time. She was born in 1908 and died in 1986 in what is now the Czech Republic. She did not start making art until she was in her early 50s. And she was really the reason why she even started making art is she was battling a bad bout of depression. She had lost a child early on in her life, so she had spent her life battling that and not really getting over it. One of her sons gave her drawing materials and she started doing these beautiful botanicals early in the morning before anybody would wake up. It was really her solitary hour. She listened to classical music. She didn't look at flowers. She used her own imagination. She also added beads and collage and all different kinds of beautiful things that add a texture to her work. So it's not just flat work, there's 3D parts to it as well.
Well, the cool thing about Paige is this gallery is not just an art gallery here in Chinatown. Tell me what makes this art gallery different than any other.
The Good Luck Gallery is the only commercial gallery in all of Los Angeles that has a focus on self-taught and outsider art. Meaning that I don't show anybody that went to school and was taught how to do this or do that. Nobody's been graded, no one's been told what was right or wrong, and it's just coming from someplace else. It's a really raw, very interesting way of making art, and it's tribal almost. You know, I'm dealing with people that have adults with disabilities. I'm dealing with people that were not educated at all, and yet here they found their voice in the art that they're making.
Okay, well also, and then you get back to the community, let's talk a little bit about that.
I do give back to the community in that I'm showing people for the first time. Most of the people that I work with haven't shown before. Anna Zumukova that's a special case. This is a slice of history that I brought into the gallery. But most of the people that I show have never shown their work before. And I look for people that wouldn't normally be willing to walk into a gallery and try and show their work, and they're not sure, and they wouldn't think that people would be interested in it. I work with people that are schizophrenic, I work with people that are autistic, I work with people that are nonverbal, I work with people that are undereducated, African-American folk artists that are 83 years old and have been making masking tape sculptures for their entire life and never thought that anybody would be interested in that. So I go out and I find those types of artists and I bring that kind of art in here and I hang it in a gallery setting and give them the attention that they deserve.
And you know, there's only 23 pieces left of Anna's work. 23, that's it, in the whole world.
Well, there's actually 100 pieces for sale, and I have 24 of them here in the gallery. And the rest of her work has been already given to institutions and things like that. Anna's work is, like I said, the most historical show I've ever done. She's very special, and it's really special that we're getting to show her work here in California.
Well, I'm excited that Paige has allowed us to come and view this amazing work, and I love the gallery. I like what it represents, and that she's giving people with disabilities, people that didn't even know they were artists, and that people can actually come and view and touch and feel and see. And we're also gonna be able to look at some other work that she has here, and I look forward to seeing Paige again. We're gonna see you soon. Okay, the Buffers. Hey, that's it for our first segment of Art in Chinatown. And you know what? We had an amazing time. We have so many more things to come to you. I'll see you another day, another time, another special event. See you soon.